6'8",
the straight cookie motherfucker. Just keep getting better, and it's shown in my game. I don't really think it's been a blow. I think people just paying attention to what I've been doing.
I asked God for forgiveness, so I can't rep on niggas. But I let God be my witness, that we done stepped on niggas. I can afford to buy army, but I stopped buying bullets. I just hope that you ain't in that car when we do catch up with them. Rather be the suspect than the victim. Keep my cool and beat the system. When I talk about you, about who?
I said winning is always number one for me, because I think if you win, everything else comes along with it, like getting offers, getting looked at by colleges, and that's the second big thing, getting to college, bringing in some scholarships from different coaches and different choices I could have at the end of the summer, even going into high school season. But I definitely want to keep getting better, keep getting stronger, bigger, faster, so I can play at the next level that I want to be at.
Speaking of college, what are you looking for in a college?
To be honest, I want to go wherever I can play, coming in as a freshman, learn, be in a good system with a good coach, and just that fits me the best and has a good academic program as well.
Oh,
player. Of course, my biggest thing is I want to win every game, whether that comes to me scoring 0 points, scoring 10 points, scoring 30 points, whatever I got to do to win. So if I got stepped up as a scorer, I'm going to do that. If I got stepped up as a defender, I'm going to do that. Just whatever to win, to be honest. And the first game, I probably should have stepped up a little bit more coming down the stretch. I didn't even get a shot up, I think, like the last. I went on like a 5-minute drive, not even getting a shot up. That hurt us a lot. And the second game, I kept playing consistent throughout the game. Guys got open looks. We sprinting the lanes, running, talking to each other, encouraging each other, and it was just a better outcome. Since I moved to Georgia, I've always kind of been the same player. I mean, the thought process between me, my family, everybody supports me, everybody being a gentleman, it just keep getting better. Those guys, a lot of guys just like kind of cancel out. They get complacent, start working hard. So the biggest thing is just keep getting better, and it's shown in my game. I don't really think it's been a blow up. I think people just paying attention to what I've been doing. It's nothing special. It's always what we had planned, though. It's going to keep going up.
Oh, my dad took it?
Uh-huh.
All right. Touch me, how are you
going? How do I feel?
Thing we're working on is rate of force development, so how fast he can develop force, and then the third one for him is just overall strength.
So much more circumference.
Bottom of the list.
You need to be
what are the two
right
most
now.
Important
So originally I'm from North Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. That's where both my parents from, but my dad joined the Army when I was like real young. So of course, like, I'm military brat. We moved around a lot. My parents, though, when they was young, we used to always go back. Like every summer, I'd stay summer out there with my cousins and stuff like that. Playing out there is definitely different from playing up here. So I used to go back out there and play in the leagues with the older guys, stuff like that. But it's definitely, it's more grittier, more skill-based. Guys getting after each other, talking. You know, almost like just up north style of basketball, how they even try to say, like, Dykeman is, all that type of stuff. They just out there competing. But it's a little different in Philly, though. Philly's just different. But you really, it put that dog in you for sure. You're going out there competing against older guys who don't care nothing about you. They trying to embarrass you in front of all these people out here. You out there competing, playing hard, getting better, shit like that. But and then I played a good percentage of basketball. And Texas was almost like the complete opposite of how it is in Philly. Texas more size based, guys getting them down, guys bigger. These niggas in fourth, fifth, sixth grade looking like damn high school. On the Vertimax already, dunking, all types of crazy stuff going down there. But Texas definitely more size based. It's skill, of course, there too, but it's just different up north and down south basketball wise. But I got the best of both worlds. So I think that definitely helped my game and where I'm at right now. But it's like a switch I can flip on. We moved to Georgia my freshman year of high school. Came to Duluth with Coach Huff. He got over there, of course, to play basketball, wanted to be on the varsity team. Of course, that was like my biggest goal my freshman year, to be on varsity and actually get minutes and stuff like that. We was like a real senior-heavy team. My dad was actually on the coaching staff. But so they was having workouts, some workouts, all that type of stuff. They in the weight room lifting, all that stuff. So we had workouts one evening, and all the coaches was in there. So, you know, I'm playing, like, they got me down there. They ain't had the varsity guys in there. They got all the freshmen and JV players working out. So we end up playing up and down or whatever. I started killing, but it's a freshman JV guy, so it don't look too good. So they have a meeting later, and they like breaking down who could play JV, who could play freshman, who could play varsity. And all the coaches was like, my freshman year, they had me proceeded as playing freshman. Or just dressing JV, not really playing JV. They had me really just playing freshman. So, you know, my dad come back and tell me this. I'm like, what? Like, I'm like, that's crazy. So we go back. They let me, my dad, like, just give him a chance. Let him work out the varsity guys. Let him work out the varsity guys. So, of course, they let me work out the varsity guys one evening. And it's like the same thing, if not different. Like, I'm out there competing with the varsity guys, holding my own, getting to where I went to on the floor. Making plays for other guys, like, I just look good. So the head coach out there, he like, damn, like, he thought it would have looked different than what it did. So they let me start practicing with the varsity team. I even get a varsity jersey. And then my freshman year, like, I played in a decent amount of varsity games. And I think I even started a couple of them. But yeah, that's pretty much how that move was when we came down here and like the transition to Georgia and the basketball and all that type. When we first decided to make the move to Berkmar, it was definitely, I tried not to, you know, tell too many people, put that move out there, give nobody nothing to talk about, because we had just made the move to, we decided to make the move to Discovery. So, like, it was going to throw everybody, like, my name was on the Cal Sandy list to go to Discovery, everything. Like, everybody knew I was going to Discovery. But, me, my mom, my dad, we sat down and we talked about it. I wanted to go to Berkmar. I think it was the best fit for me. And, like, over there, we definitely had a chance to win the state championship. Like, you seen, we made it all the way there, just going to finish or whatever. But, like, a lot of people told me it was a dumb move, or I'm be good at Discovery, I don't need to go nowhere, stuff like that. But I don't know. I was just, like, I just felt like in the long run, that would be the better decision for me. And at the time, I didn't really care what too many people had to say about the move or the transition. I was like, as long as my mom and my dad was like supportive of it, then I was good with it. Are you dressed up?
You said what?
Are you dressed?
Doing our science today.
Are you doing yours today too?
Yeah.
What the fuck?
Everybody is.
I think you said
it. I posted it. Hey, you watch my story.
No, I did not do that, bro.
Yeah. They got no excuse.
Nah, bro. You have no. Where your mom at?
She in the. She at my table.
Y'all was gonna have a whole sign on.
You good, man. That's
good, bro.
She good
with
you.
Bro!
I did it. Oh, I did it. Clap.
What's in the back? Mm-hmm. We're y'all working up.
Hey.
Yo.
Anyway, so again, welcome. If you had asked me a year ago if we would have gotten to this point, I don't know that there would have been a whole lot of believers. And so we're just super excited to have this opportunity to celebrate. What a great year, team-wise.
I love sports, and as a principal of high school, you're supposed to show up at games pretty often, here and there, every now and then. I show up at as many of them as I can possibly come. Not because I have to, but just because I love it. I love to see young people in competition. I love to cheer on the sidelines. It's one of the things that makes this job the most fun.
16 points a game for us this year, 6 rebounds a game, leading scorer on the team. Ian is a 2-time All-Region player for us, second leading scorer in Discovery history. Ian was a 4-year varsity player here at Discovery High School, and most importantly, is finishing up with a 3.7 GPA here at Discovery High School.
I just want to big shout out to my family, obviously. Love all of y'all. Big shout out to all my coaches. Love y'all. Big shout out to my brothers, man. I'm sitting right here, man. Love every single one of y'all, man. Big shout out to them 3 dudes back there. I used to look up to them, man. All 3 of them. Yeah, love all y'all, man. Everybody that came out, appreciate it. And a big thank you to Discovery. I'll be attending Georgia College and State University.
Averaged 11 points a game for us this year, 9 rebounds per game. He was an all-region player. He was the defensive player of the year in our region, and is also a 3.0 GPA.
First, I want to thank God for giving me a God-given ability to play basketball. I want to thank my mom for all the sacrifices she made for me. I want to thank Duke K. for putting time into me for my first year here, and I want to thank all my teammates and everybody just investing time with me. Thank y'all for real. Oh, and I'm going to Miami University in South Carolina.
To be honest, I really still think about it up until this day. It was a lot of different key plays and moments down the stretch, I think, that hurt us bad. But one of the plays that's always going to stick with me is those, I missed 2 free throws towards the end of the game. I think we was down 1 point. I think if we was on a scoring drive right for that too, if I hit those 2 free throws, it changes not only momentum of the game, but just like the whole atmosphere, the crowd, everything. Of course, if I could, I would go back and get those two free throws, but just be prepared for it. I mean, every day I shoot about 200, 300 free throws a day, just replaying that moment in my head to make sure I won't let it happen again. But it definitely taught me a lot. It was a great experience going down there to make it. And I think we'll be back next year. Of course, I knew Rob since I think my freshman year. And every time I played with or against Rob, it's always fun. We always talking to each other, talking shit to each other, competing, pushing each other. But Rob, like over the years, he done got way better. Rob used to trip after every move he made, miss all his layups, couldn't hit a jump shot. Now, like, he really come into his own. So when we compete, it's even more fun. It's more competitive now. We're talking shit to each other. He really dribbling the ball. It's getting hard for me to take it from him. He finishing at the rim well, but every time we compete, it's always fun. It's always a show. And they end up beating us, but we won't have Nick again. So I know every year, I think Hoop Scene hosts it at Suwannee Sports Academy, but Bob Yin is usually a real big tournament. A lot of good teams come out and play, stuff like that. But to be honest, it's another day. I work out throughout the week and on the weekends, every day, three times a day, to be prepared for stuff like that. So when I get out there, just another game, I'm just playing. Of course, the goal is to try to win it all, and that's definitely what I'm going to try to get done this weekend and put my name maybe out there even more, but really come out there and compete and show why I'm one of the best in the state and arguably the country.
Oh, it does.